Now, when you teach an activity to your class, make sure that all of your students can understand.
It can be very confusing if someone doesn't understand.
We've all been there before.
Yes.
Yep. Okay, Katie, drop the oars in the water. Oh no, wait. First, lock the oars in place and then drop them in the water.
When giving instruction, make sure you plan what you're going to say and write it on a piece of paper.
Right, and before class, practice, either alone or with someone else. This will increase your confidence.
Before you start, make sure all your students are listening.
That is a good tip.
Yeah, I thought you'd like that one.
Ooh, I thought of another good tip. Use simple language.
Today, class, we will sing Ring Around the Rosie. Everybody, stand up and form a circle. Great. You can also say, find your partner or pair up.
Or you might want to put students in pairs on your own. That will save a lot of time.
Good idea.
Okay, class, now I will put you into pairs. You two are partners. You two are partners. And you two are partners. Great, let's play our game.
Tell your students, this activity will take 15 minutes, or this is going to take 20 minutes.
Time limits are so important. Students need to know how long they have to do the activity. It's really helpful.
It's a good thing. Okay, class, time is up. Class, today, we will draw blackbirds. This activity will take 10 minutes. Then, you will use your blackbirds to sing the song, Two Little Blackbirds.
And use body language when you give instructions. So, open the book. Speak loudly. Listen, please. Cut paper. Nod your head. And if the activity is very long, if it has a lot of instructions, don't give them all at once. Break them up into parts.
Students might forget instructions you gave them earlier.
Right.
That can be confusing.
I can't wait to get started.
Oh, let's wait until we read the instructions.
Okay.
I'll read the instructions. Okay. We can do the experiment now.
Let's do it. Whew. Oh, wait, I forget. What came first? Oh, anyway.
No, Anna!